So in the United States, up to 85% of Americans will suffer from some episode of spine pain that will put them out of commission for 3 days up to 3 weeks. And once you have one episode, the likelihood of having more episodes go up exponentially. So it's obviously a problem here in the United States. So we get asked all the time, so where does this spine pain come from, right? What causes spine pain? And so spine pain isn't exactly spine pain, right? It's not actually the bones that hurt, but it's everything that goes around the spine, the neck, the upper back, the lower back. And real simply, from what we've seen, if you go out and you rake the yard for 4 hours and you're not used to raking the yard, it makes sense that your back's going to get a little sore. It's going to start to hurt the next day. You're going to get out of bed a little slow. But what happens within, 2 to 4 days, those muscles repair themselves, they heal, and that spine pain goes away. Now, it's the repetitive spine, it's the chronic pain in the neck and the lower back that has a deeper source. And what we have found is, believe it or not, most of the time, spine pain, back pain, upper back pain, even neck pain, all comes from one place. One place. And I'll promise you this, it's not from a drug deficiency. So taking medications is never going to fix your spine pain. They might mask it so you don't feel it, but it's never going to fix anything. So what we have found is almost every single time, spine pain starts in the neck at the top of the spine. It's where it starts. And then like a domino effect, it over time works its way down the spine to where down in the lower back, which supports the majority of your weight, becomes weak. And then it just takes that right movement, the right direction, and boom, it got you, right? You ever heard of somebody like bend over to pick up their toothbrush and their back went out? Well, obviously it wasn't the weight of that toothbrush that threw their back out, right? There was a weakness and it just took the right movement, the right direction, and oh, it got you, right? Well, what we have found is almost 100% of the time, that all starts right up here at the very top of the neck. You see, your head is designed to be level. It has to be balanced always. There's something that's called the riding reflex. It's a reflex to make sure the brain's always level. Well, if one of the bones in the top of the neck got misaligned, maybe it was years ago, a slip, a fall, a car accident, a sports injuries, there's a million different ways that one of these top little bones can get just a little bit out of place. Now, what that does is it throws your head off balance. Well, your brain doesn't like it. And so that riding reflex kicks in and forces your body to compensate till the head levels. Now, when this bone gets out of line, throws the head off, the brain doesn't like it, but it can't fix the misalignment. It's stuck. So what it does is your body will compensate for the misalignment. When it goes this way, your body will compensate and it'll pull one hip up and it's going to make curves in your spine. If this happens early enough in life while you're still growing, that's where scoliosis comes from majority of the time. But as an adult, you don't get the curves in your spine. You just get kind of twists and turns and compensations, all about trying to get that head level. Now what happens is you have compensatory changes as your spine changes. It drops one shoulder, pulls up one hip, makes one leg short. So what that does is create weaknesses that can result in neck pain, headaches, shoulder pain, arm pain, back pain, hip pain, knee pain, foot pain. So you can imagine if your body's designed to fight off gravity straight perpendicular to the ground, and if your body starts to now get some little turns and twists in there, then those little bends and turns create weaknesses that just take that right movement and bam, it got you. So if you've been suffering from chronic spine pain anywhere up and down your spine, then the best thing that I can recommend is to at least get this area checked. What we have found is so many times, I can't tell you how people come in and their back's killing them. They get so bad, herniated discs that are so painful, we can't even touch them. But we'll correct the top bone in their neck. And then all of a sudden, even while they're resting, the spine starts moving and starts unwinding. They get up and all of a sudden the pain's gone. It's that easy. Now, the thing is we have to find out the cause, okay? The only way to do that is to go to an upper cervical doctor, let them check this area to see if you have a misalignment here. Let me also add this. You don't have to have neck pain to have a misalignment here. There's no pain perception actually at the brainstem, so that bone could be out of alignment and just cause your body to compensate without having any neck pain whatsoever. But it could have created those weaknesses in other parts of your spine that are now resulting in pain. Could be have pain down the leg, pain down the arm. So find an upper cervical doctor near you. Go in for a consultation exam. Let's see if there's a problem there. If you live in the Charlotte area, Gastonia, Belmont, Mount Holly, Huntersville, Cornelius, Lake Norman, Lake Wiley, Matthews, Pine, give our office a call. We'll be happy to offer you a free consultation just to come in and talk with one of our doctors to see if your spine pain could be the result of a bone in your neck. If it is, we'll explain to you what we need to do and exactly what it's going to take to correct the problem. If it's not a problem in your neck, then we will try to find someone else that we believe can better serve you, and we would definitely refer you to them. So give our office a call, 704-588-5560. We look forward to seeing you soon and see if we can help you remove that spine pain once and for all. Have a great day.